We're still in the madame's
boudoir.
This Zaiwass. Dead clunk. Oh, I can change the time. There's a few sort of like, oh no, they're moving, they're just light shadows. I thought they were clean areas where the dust wasn't.
Beautiful pieces for sure. They must be worth a fortune.
So am I looking
These
for
books
time?
Are here for a reason. They mean something.
Yeah,
These
so I think
books
I'm looking
are here
for... Yeah, you said that. I think I'm looking for a time. Seven pieces of my mind? Seven... Not just 7:49, is it? I'm not seeing any other numbers. Give it a try. 7... That must be about there. Oh, it'd be 7:49, so it'd be over here, wouldn't it? Oh.
A hidden door. Who'd have thought? She is a legendary ex-spy. Well, this is something I've never understood. Why isn't a key good enough? I mean, you can take that with you, but riddles can be solved by anyone.
I don't think many animals get to be in this room, Marty. The other thing is...
Maybe she wanted us to find it.
Exactly what I'm thinking. Who knows? Anyway, we're going in.
So this room is not like her at all.
The other must have been for show. Marty, this is the reality. We're talking about a professional spy.
A former spy.
Still, if anyone knows how to mask her real face, it's her.
But you think this is who she really is? Cold, dark, and tiny.
And full of secrets.
Ladies of the Force, 872. Oh, is that? It's one of that.
So the rumors are true. Makes sense. You think she's still working for Royal Intelligence?
But can I go?
Based on what she told us, she...
So the rumors are true.
Military intelligence. This dame's really something. I'm starting to think the whole brothel is just a cover.
Makes sense. You think she's still working for Royal Intelligence?
Based on what she told us, she's a committed royalist. So I imagine she does.
Hector III, our great and fair king.
I feel sorry for the poor fox, to be honest.
I don't. He has it pretty good.
Would you like to live your life as a puppet? Everything you do, carefully planned. Your rule and authority, the whole thing, just for show.
Even if he is just a puppet, Clawville needs a king. He gives strength and hope to many animals.
I guess.
Got drawers.
Names, numbers, dates. Oh, furry gods.
Do you think they all belong to the brothel?
Hell no. Half of it is a matter of national security.
What did we step into?
You know what? I don't care, Marty. I'm too old for conspiracies. The only thing that matters to me is to find out what the furry hell we're doing here.
And what it has to do with Natasha.
Sure.
Walls.
This place gives me the creeps.
Me too. We better get out of here before she comes back.
Draws Tepeta. Oh. Ancient Angel Colomar. About separatist group movements, code definition moon, delivery parrot, grass, shining angel wings. 6.
Somebody started typing a letter but left it unfinished.
What does it say?
Number 2947222. Report about separatist group movements.
Damn it. Don't even read that.
What? Why not?
I don't know about you, but I don't want to get caught up in the royalist-separatist conflict. What you don't know can't hurt you, right?
I can't even recognize you, boss. Where did you put your sense of adventure?
My sense of adventure has retired. Leave it alone.
Bring it out of retirement for one last go. The book.
This has got to be it, Marty. Look at the missing page.
Oh, gods. And look at the names.
Yeah, the ladies and their guests.
Uh-huh. Damn.
What this means, Marty,
it's a lot of bribe
is that the
pretension.
Most influential people in the city had been Natasha's patrons. Some even from the royal family.
This book could destabilize Clawville.
At least the Clawville we currently know.
You think this is behind everything? Somebody's blackmailing Natasha because of this?
That could easily be the case. But something still doesn't fit. That piece of a painting.
Sonny?
If there's even a small chance of...
Sonny.
What?
There's another familiar name here.
What are you talking about?
Who? Molly Starling? She's the police.
Fucking hell, Sonny. Molly?
She was working here too.
It's probably someone else with the same name.
So that's
just the
why.
Secretary of the police
Natasha
station?
Natasha told me they'd known each other for a long time.
Look, boss.
I can't believe it. All those stories about her past.
Listen, Bossbird. Molly loved you, right?
Oh, was that?
Isn't that what matters?
Marty, please shut your fucking beak right now or I'll shut it for you.
Oh, just Sonny's
okay,
ex.
Boss. I'm sorry, but...
Just shut the cluck up.
We've caught them sneaking around, Miss Diamond, you see?
I see, madam.
Oh, back off, ladies.
Wait a minute, are
there's
they wearing
no need
fur?
For this.
Well,
we
just
don't want
that.
Trouble.
No, maybe you don't. Unfortunately, trouble has found you, gentlemen.
Madam Zaiwass, we needed to know the connection. What this place has to do with Natasha. And my wife.
Filthy cops? He's talking gibberish. May I shoot him?
No, not yet, Miss Diamond.
I'd be very sorry to put holes in your lovely striped skin, but believe me, baby, I will. I've always wanted to know if diamonds are bulletproof.
Please, madam. It'll all be over in a second.
No. We have received different orders, Miss Diamond.
Oh.
Stand down.
Oh, I see. The pony does tricks on command. Well, I'm not surprised.
That's enough, Marty. You knew who she was, didn't you? What she meant to me.
Well, well, Mr. Featherland. Aren't you interested in your case anymore? No? All it took was a name from your past, and your professionalism drowned in the mud.
Stop playing games with me, Zaiwass. What does all this have to do with Molly?
Nothing at all. No, she was just a little bird among the many who sought refuge here.
You forced her into this.
You'd love to hear that, but until she met you, she was one of us. Just another...
You clucking...
Sonny, no!
I think I was dreaming, but it wasn't the kind of dream you'd want to remember.
Whoa.
Dark and painful, Then the suffocating smoke woke me. It wasn't fried eggs, that's for sure. Where was I? What happened? That treacherous crocodile. Then I saw Marty, who looked as horrible as I felt. Well, I've always wanted a romantic sea voyage.
God damn it. Oh. I knew I shouldn't have gone along with this.
Marty, I told you you could get out any time.
And you knew damn well that I wouldn't. That I would never leave you in deep shit once I've joined you. You knew it, and you still asked me to do it.
Marty, listen.
You're a selfish bastard, Sonny. And you drag everyone around you down with you. How long was it till retirement? 120 days?
121.
But you just couldn't sit still on your ass, could you? Well, take a good look around, boss bird. This is you. And this is what follows you. Just this clucking misery. And dead bodies. Do you understand? You have nothing else to offer but suffering.
Marty.
And feeling sorry for yourself. Oh, you're great at that. I can't believe this shit. We're gonna die here on a goddamn blazing ship like roast chicken. Well, it's dramatic at least, just like you like it.
Marty.
What?
I've almost managed to untie the knot, but if you keep thrashing around like that, we're really gonna die here.
Ah, for cluck's sake. Fine. Work your magic. Until then, I'm gonna say all the prayers I know.
You better.
Uh-oh.
We'll be fried chicken. I hope there are spices in those barrels at least.
Oh, okay. We'll just trace it. Oh, now I've only just noticed the timer.
So what now?
Hey!
Now we run and swim.
I can't swim.
Well, you better learn fast or you'll die. I'm not gonna drag your fat ass to the shore if that's what you're hoping.
Well, I shouldn't have brought this many guns with me.
Throw them away then.
Never!
Then they'll drag you down into the deep. Ah, I don't care. I always thought your gun mania would be your undoing.
Cluck you, Sonny.
We have to survive this first.
Well, after you, boss bird.
That furry fucking clucking gods, damn.
Yeah.
Listen, Marty.
What?
What you said on the ship.
What about it?
You were right. I knew this would happen. Or something like it. I dragged you into this deliberately. Because I'm not enough on my own.
Sonny, cut the crap.
No, I'm serious. I knew I couldn't do this alone. I needed you to... well, to look out for me.
I don't need this, all right? Stop playing the wounded soul. I don't fucking care.
Fair enough. You're right.
Hell yeah, I'm fucking right.
Shut up now.
Good.
Captain Marsh, the city.
Clawville, you tried it again, but I'm still alive. You've seen better days too, haven't you?
Have we lost Marty then? Oh no, that's Marty.
You can swim after all.
Yeah, or the river spat me out.
Well, what about your guns? Did you throw them away?
Hell no. Where they go, I go. And where I go, they're coming with me no matter what.
I'm seriously amazed you're still alive.
It might be a bit damp, though.
Yeah, sure.
I'm glad you made it, partner.
You know, I have a feeling this night's just getting started.
We were almost finished.
Yeah.
You don't want to quit, do you?
No, Sonny, I don't.
Thanks, partner.
Yeah.
Oh.
Well, anyway, I'm glad we both made it.
Yeah, thanks. I must admit you were pretty dope with that rope.
But still, cluck me. Am I right?
Without you, we wouldn't even be in this mess. So if you weren't successful with the rope, I would have strangled you before we both burnt to death.
Nice thought. But your hands were tied, so...
Sonny.
Okay, you're right. And now we'll have to see where this shitstorm ends.
Yeah, I know.
Burning us, along with a ship, that's pretty dramatic.
Yeah.
You stepped in big dung, that's for sure. Do you think Wessler and the crocodile are in it together?
I get the feeling that whoever hit us wasn't a pretty gal.
Yeah, figures.
All right, hello, Captain.
Cluck me. That's old Captain Marsh. I thought he died 50 years ago.
Is he a... What is he? Beaver? Let's see his tail.
I think I must have hit my head pretty badly.
Say, isn't that Captain Marsh?
You see him too? Oh, thank the gods.
Ho, 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 lads. What the hairy devil are you doing out here? Isn't it a bit cold for a swim?
It was warm on the ship, at least while it was burning.
I bet it was. Arr.
Hey, Captain, how's it hanging?
It's hanging all right. Arr. What about you lubbers? What was all that ruckus, eh?
Oh, I think someone tried to kill us, Captain. Again.
Come on, Boise. There's nothing new there.
Yeah, old rust can't be scraped away.
Did you see anything, Captain?
Arr! Of course I have. A burning ship. Then two cocks suddenly learned to fly. And even swim, by gad. Huh. What a time to be alive, eh?
You haven't changed a bit, old man.
Sure I haven't. I'm steady, like the Sea of Clawville.
Yeah, except that Clawville doesn't have a sea.
Of course it does, laddie. Just not here in Clawville.
Okay. That's too much for me.
Ooh. Oh. Hatches. Meredith. Marble. I wonder how many of those I've missed. Because they don't pop up on this thing. We... asking, right?
Tell me, Captain, do you hang out here all the time?
This behind me is me ship, lads. Or at least, it's a ship I'm living in at the moment. It's not mine, you know.
What, the burning one?
And what do you do?
I stand here and watch the sea.
The sea? You mean the River Thames?
River? Arr, that was a good one, boy.
Okay.
A black car stopped not far from here. A rich-looking car. Shiny and all.
Yeah? What else?
Two big lads stepped out of it. One of them was looking like some kind of cow. The other was a cat, a big cat. They were fancy looking at the ship. I don't blame them. It's not something you see every day. I swear on all the saints of the sea. Arr.
Just a wild guess. Was it a ram and a bobcat?
Arr, exactly. Are you friends of theirs?
Not exactly.
Well, an acquaintance. It's the bouncer of the Tsar Club, and the goon that was hanging around Ibn.
Plumy gods! Zaiwass answers to Ibn too. Or at least they're connected.
Yeah.
Oh, arr. That sounds exciting.
Maybe the other way around.
Old-timer.
bouncer?
This Ram fella. What did he do after watching us?
Nothing at all, Eddie. When that lovely ship started to sink, they got into their pretty car and got away like bats out of hell.
So they didn't see us swimming to shore.
I wouldn't know that.
What now?
I don't know. We can't go to the station, that's for sure.
We agree on that.
I think I broke a rib or two.
My sight's getting blurry.
Pluck me. You know what this means?
Oh, no, no. I'd rather go blind than go to Bubo's.
We have to, pal.
I'm not your pal, especially after tonight.
Come on, Bubo. We got no choice.
Bubo, Bubo.
Well, we survived the burning ship. I guess we'll survive the madman, too.
Don't be so optimistic.
All right. Was that everything? No, no.
Do you know anything about the place called the Sweltering Nile?
Of course I do, me boys. But they don't really tolerate folks like me there.
Not surprised. Have you heard anything unusual about it?
Sure I have. They have the most beautiful wenches there, laddie. Like sirens of the sea. And they're willing to do anything for you. If only I were a spring chicken like ye are, I'd be already running over there.
Well, actually, Captain, that's where we came from.
On a burning ship? Bloody hell! You know how to live, lads.
We're doing our best, Captain.
Hey, yippee!
Have you heard the name Madame Zaiwass?
When I was young like ye, they were talking about a gorgeous crocodile with that name. Aye, beautiful and deadly. Just how I like my women.
Me too.
It's her, yeah. Less beautiful now, but just as deadly.
She has something to do with the burning ship, aye?
You're quite the detective.
So I've been told.
All right, so I think we now need to... Oh, let's... What have we got in here? Clues. Molly's name popped up where I expected it the least, in Madame Zaiwass' book. Zaiwass tried to do away with us, but why? Is she in cahoots with Ibn Wesler? I think she's higher up the pecking order than Ibn. Marty's right. I was an extremely selfish bastard. There's nothing to be done now. We're already here, and I have the feeling he's going to stand by my side until the very end, as always. Who will riddle your feathers with holes without a thought if she has to? Captain Marsh is... Oh, it's a capybara. Talks like a real pirate and smells like one too. The captain is a much greater legend than we'll ever be. Everyone just calls him the captain. He most likely never left the shore in his life. He's an innocent guy indeed, but maybe he saw something useful. I feel sorry for him, but sometimes I think he's the only sane figure in the whole city nowadays. Really? Dr. Reginald B. Booba. Eagle Owl. Booba Booba. Morpheus, neurotic, old and ugly, but he's an old friend from the golden days of the chicken place. Bubo's a true institution. He keeps most of Clawville's gangsters intact and alive, and sometimes even helps cops who'd like to get repaired unofficially. For the right compensation, of course. It's just this. What's this? Who's this? the docks. Here lives Captain Marsh, who probably never was a real captain, but is still one of the most righteous fellas I've ever met. Old Boobo's apartment is also his office, and I'm sure it's not legal in any way, almost like in my case. Of course, my apartment is not full of organs and limbs, as far as I know, at least. All right. Well, hello, there's... What else is there? I said there was two places. Well, I guess we go to Boobo's and get stitched up.